Yo, David, this is a video you requested, okay? So I'm going to be showing you how to actually use JDBC, okay, and what it's actually. Now, JDBC stands for Java Database Connectivity. Now, it's an API for Java, for connecting Java projects, okay, Java applications to a database. Now, you see that you have two things inside. You have Java application and you have database. Now you have a Java application on one side and a database on the other side. Now you will need something, you need like a connection between them, right? And that connection is offered to you by what you call a driver class. A driver class is a class file that actually has information about a certain database. In our case, since I'm using MySQL, you also use MySQL. I'm sure you have XAMPP, because as you can see, XAMPP I'm going to be using here with the MySQL server, okay? The driver class in this case is going to be MySQL connector. Okay, now I'm going to go right ahead and show you where mine is. Mine is in my program files, Java. This is it, MySQL connector, Java. This jar, okay. When you're creating a Java application, you actually need to import this jar, okay, into your project, the project that is going to be communicating with the database. You see a bit. So that's basically all what you need to do, okay. So let me just go right ahead and open my Eclipse. Well, I just have 4 GB RAM, so can you already imagine? Okay. Taking longer than expected. Ah, let's wait. Okay, nice. So what I'm going to be doing is that I'm going to create three classes, okay? I'm going to create a project. That project will have a single package, and that package will have three classes, okay? In one of those three classes will be my model class, meaning that it is the class that is actually going to serve as a link between my Java application or my project, my Java project, and my database. Okay. Now inside, now I'll use my driver manager class from the java.sql package. Okay. So let me just jump right ahead and create the projects. Okay, Java project. I'm going to call that project GodMask. Okay, you know why. Next. Now I will not create a module info.java. I have this. I'm going to add an external jar. You can already imagine it will be my MySQL connector Java. So I told you this is the jar that actually has the driver class for MySQL that you need in your Java project that is going to communicate with a database. So I include it, and basically I just hit finish. Okay, so this is it, GodMask. Now this is empty, so I'm going to go right ahead and create a package that I'm going to call GodMask. Why not? Okay, GodMask. And then now in this one, I'm going to create three classes. The first class will be my model class. Okay, I don't want it to be a runnable class. I want it to be a utility class. A utility class is simply a class that cannot run. Okay, it doesn't have the static void main. Okay, it's just there to supplement the project. It's just there as a supplementary class. Okay, so I hit finish. Okay, now I'm going to create another one called store. Now this is where I'm going to create it's not going to be a utility class, okay, because I actually need it to run. Now this is where I'm actually going to send values into my database. Okay, okay, and then I'll create the last one that I'm going to call, obviously I think you can already imagine, retrieve. This is what I'm going to use to retrieve the information I just stored, okay, into the database. And this is actually where I'm also going to be creating new stuff here, right? Well, we shall see about that. So I hit finish. Okay, So let's start with the model. In the model, I have my package. So what you, the first thing you need to realize is that since the model is the one communicating with the database, I'll need the CQL package, okay? And I'll need, the first thing is that I'll need connection, okay? Because this is actually what you're going to use to create a connection. Okay, now I need Java SQL driver manager. Okay, this is the guy that manages the driver class. Okay, it's like he gets I think you know what I mean here. Okay, then you have import java.sql.prepared statement. A prepared statement is a statement that has unknowns. Just think of the MySQL, a particular SQL command, okay? It's of the form, let me just write it somewhere as a comment. Well, I'm going to show you what a prepared statement is anyway. So import java.sql. I'm going to use a SQL exception. So whenever there is a problem, I need actually this to capture the exception, okay? So yeah, all what I'm going to do is I'm going to create two fields, okay? Private name, private string, sorry, name, okay? And I'm going to create private int age, okay? Basically, now I'm going to create a constructor for this class, public model, okay? It will take a string called name and a string and an int called age, okay? And basically I need this dot name to be the name and this dot age to be the age, okay? Now this means the particular instance object that called that was created, okay? So this is it. Now that was for the constructor. Now this is the following method is the one that will actually create the connection, okay? / transactions for the database, okay? So I'm going to call it public boolean, public boolean create user. Why not create user? Okay, now boolean, I'm going to add a boolean here, like private boolean success. This is going to tell us if it's actual, if the what happened here actually succeeded, okay? So I'm going to put everything here inside a try catch, okay? Sorry, I'm going to put everything inside a try catch. I'm going to catch a SQL exception, e dot print stack trace. Okay, now SQL exception. Okay, now it's actually red because nothing has shown the exception yet. Okay, so now yeah, I'm going to create my connection. Okay, connection con equals new. Okay, I'm actually saying new because you see why I'm saying that. For now I have the next one that is going to be my prepared statement. This is actually what will throw the exception, okay? Prepared statement PS is equals to, I'll say con dot prepare statement, okay? This is actually what prepares the statement, and here you have to put the SQL string, okay? So I'm just going to leave it as SQL. So up here I'm going to create, after creating, I'm going to create a string called SQL string, SQL is equals. Now what we want to do is insert stuff into the database. So I'm going to say insert into the name of our table will be users, of course. Insert within these users, I'll put the name, comma, age, okay, and then I'll say values, and I'll put question mark. This is what I call a prepared statement, okay? This is a prepared statement. A prepared statement is a statement that has, it's a normal SQL statement that has question marks, has unknowns. You see a bit, it has unknowns. Now the unknowns are going to be given here. So now this is true. This is this statement, that this prepared statement that actually throws a SQL exception. Okay, now you have your connection, which is new for the moment, of course. You have your SQL command, which is inserted into users, name, comma, age, values, this, and then you have a prepared statement, conduct, prepare this, okay. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is actually create the connection. So, con equals to driver manager, okay, dot get connection. Now in the get connection, I have to put a string. Now that string is as follows. The first thing is a GDBC, okay, that the Java database connectivity, okay, two dots, that's a colon. Then comes the name of the database server you're using. So I'm using MySQL, okay, colon, okay. After the colon, now you have to put two forward slashes, okay. Then you put local host, that is, which type of host are you? Are you a local host or are you a global host? Okay, then now you put a colon again. Okay, you put the port number of the SQL server. In this case, XAMPP, it is 3306 for MySQL. Okay, so you have 3306, and then now all you need to do is put a forward slash, and then you put now the name of the database. Well, I've never created it, so, but I'll be creating it, and I'll call it UserDB. Okay, after putting that, I have to put a question mark and say user equals, the user will be user db user. Funny name, right? And then, and the password will be 12345. Okay, that will be the password. So basically that's it. I've created my connection. Okay, the connection is created. So I have the GDBC colon MySQL, okay, which is a server, colon, two forward slashes, local host, which is the type of user I am, colon, 3306, which is the port number for the MySQL server, forward slash, I have the database name, which is UserDB, question mark, then comes the user equals the name of the user that's using this database, in my case is UserDB user, and a bitwise, and you have password, my password 12345. So basically we have created a connection. Okay, so now I want to be inserting stuff into the connection. So I'm going to say now con.set auto commit. This is actually, I'm going to set it to false. This is actually what starts the transaction. Okay, you know what a transaction is in database or relational database terminology or concept. Okay, a transaction is an operation that you can perform on a database. Okay, a single operation. Okay, so now in this case, this starts the transaction, this particular transaction. So now, since I have a prepared statement here, what I want to do is I want to set what these values are. And for me to set what those values are, I need to use the PS, the prepared statement we use. So dot set. Now in this case, I'm going to set, the first thing I'm going to set is a string, because the first question mark here is a name, and that name is a string. Okay, so I'm going to say set string. I'm going to put the name, and I'm going to put this dot name. Okay, the name that was passed to this object that was created. Okay, and here I'm going to put one, because it's actually the first. Okay, the first thing here. So why are they saying name and one? I swapped them. You're supposed to put, say that this the first is the first, so this name. Okay, so you are saying that what I'm setting is the first question mark, and that the value is this name, so the name of this particular object. Now the second thing now is ps.set int, because the age is an int, so it's the second, and it's actually this dot age. Okay, so that's it. So I've finished setting them. After setting them, all I need to do is execute now the command. So I'm going to say ps dot Now, actually, I'm going to store now this in success, okay? ps.execute, okay? ps.execute. Now, for this, well, I'm going to say, but let me just say now. Now, ps, this execute returns true if the result of the execute command is actually a result set. You know what a result set is, right? A result set is just an object that holds the various rows of the database of the table of a particular table in the database that will return due to the command. Okay, that's a result set. Basically, you have is a select command that returns result sets. Okay, now if this part, this expression actually returns a true, it means that result set is available, meaning that it has rows. Okay, but if it returns false, it means that you just did a count or an update operation in the database, like insert, and in our case it's insert, so we're expecting success to be false for the whole thing to be true. Okay, so now basically that's just it there, that's just it. And then now down here you just say con.commit, you commit the transaction. Okay, you commit the transaction, you know what it means, right? And then now all you need to do is now you close, ps.close. Close releases the resources of the object, of the prepared statement object, okay, and of the connection. It releases it. Okay, so now I have my trial, my catch. Okay, so basically that's just it. So I have to return now, return success. Okay, I return success. Okay, I return that boolean. Okay, I'm going to be using it as a condition in my next, and that's just it. That's just all. Okay, basically that's just it. Okay, this one communicates with your database. Okay, so now install, I'm actually going to be creating. So first of all, I want to import java.util.scanner. Okay, I want to import scanner because I need the person, the user, to be able to input stuff, command prompt. So from the console down here, okay, so I have this now. Yeah, I'm just going to create a scanner object, input name. Okay, new scanner. Okay, that takes system.in. okay, now that I've created it, I'll say system.out.print. okay, and I'm saying okay, enter your name, and there I say name equals string name equals input name dot next line. Okay, now this will take the name and store it in the name. So I'm going to create another scanner input age equals new scanner system dot in. Okay, and then now I'm going to say okay, system dot out dot print. Okay, and then yeah, I'm going to say enter your age. Okay, and then now I'm going to say input age dot next int. Okay, voila. So I take this, and then all I need to do now is create a model. My model is equals to new model. Okay, I create an instance of my model and I pass it name and age. Was it not age? Oh, sorry. Okay, yeah, I need to say int age. Okay, and that's just it. After I've created it, I just need to say my model dot create user. Okay, I just need to actually say like boolean result, okay, because this actually returns a boolean, okay. So basically that's it, and I say if not result, meaning that if it's false, I will say connection sorry system.out.println success of that's lame. I'm going to say something like user was successfully added. Okay, user was successfully added. Well, else, well, if it fails, I'm just going to say return. Okay, I'm just going to return simply. Okay, basically that's just all what this does. Okay, that's just all it does. And then now my retrieve now will actually help me now get this guy. So I'm here, I'm going to import the java.sql.connection. I'm going to import the java.sql.driver manager. I'm going to import java.sql.statement. In this case, I'm going to use a statement now, not a prepared statement. And then now I have my import java.sql.sql exception. Sorry, exception. Okay. Yeah, I forgot one thing. java.sql.result set, because we're actually going to be using a select statement here, so we actually need a result set that will hold the what is returned by that. So basically in main, I'm going to like create a connection. Of course, I'm going to put everything in a try catch. Okay, I'm going to put everything in a try catch. SQL exception E, and I'm going to say E.print stack trace for more information about any error that might come into play. So inside here, I'm going to say connection con, okay, equals new. Again, I'm going to say result set RS is equal new again. Okay, so and then I'm going to say I'm going to create a query, okay, that is going to be a string query is equals to, okay, in this screen I'm just going to say select star from, okay, so our database was users, if I remember. The name of the table, well, I said the name of the table, we're going to call it user or users, I don't remember, let me check, users with S, select star from users. So this is it. So now all I need to do is statement equals conduct create statement, okay, create statement. Now that I've created a statement, you see that this is the one that actually throws a SQL exception. I will say stm, okay, dot execute query, okay, and in this query I'm going to put my query. Okay, so now I want this to be in a result set, okay, because this statement actually executes this, sends it to the database and blah blah blah, executes and everything. Okay, so now before I can even do this, I'll actually need my connection to be actually running. So I'm going to say conduct driver manager dot get connection, and in the connection I'm just going to, you know, well, I've written it already, so I'm just gonna copy and paste. Copy, paste. Sorry, this is supposed to be an equal to. Okay, so now after I create my statement and then I execute a query which returns this. Okay, return this. So now all I need to do is check. Okay, I need to check if rs dot next. Okay, as you can see, they say next moves the cursor forward one row from its current position. Okay, this verifies that you actually have a row. Okay, they say a resource cursor is initially positioned before the first row. Okay, the first call to the method next makes the first row the current row, the second call makes the second, and so forth. You see a bit. So basically I'm checking here if there's actually a result. Okay, if there's actually a row, if there is a result, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to want to I want to print that result. Okay, so I'm going to say system.out.println. So inside I'm going to say the name of user is plus, I'm going to say rs.next, get string. Okay, and then I just put the column index. Okay, now in this case the column index doesn't start as zero as you might think. The first column in this case is one. Okay, and that one corresponds to the name. Okay, the name column, you know that our user's table will have just two columns, name and age. Okay, so basically that is it. And then I'll have system.out.println. Okay, and then I'll have his/age is, okay, and then I say plus rs.getInt, and I put 2 because it's the second column of my table. Okay, so here I'm instead going to say while. Okay, I'm going to say while so that if we have many rows, it will first print the first row, then print the second row, and so on and so forth. Okay, so I'm just going to put like system.out.println. Okay, just like, okay, it will just print an empty line. Okay, okay, while this is true, this, okay, and that's it. Basically that's just it. And then finally all I need to do is actually close, close now. So rs.close, okay, I close it, and I close also, this just liberates the resources. Okay, it liberates the resources, it clears out any object that was held by rs, and then garbage collects it, and same thing for the connection. Okay, basically that's just it. Okay, that's just it, we're done. Okay, we're done. So all we need to do now is actually create that table in our database. Now the MySQL server is running, so I'm going to go ahead and go to create xampp mysql-bin, since this is where the MySQL server is located, in your xampp folder. Okay, when you install xampp, now the next thing you do is type mysql --user root. Now root is the guy that has all the privileges here. Okay, and then you type password. Now his password is empty, so you just hit enter. So now here I'll be creating a database, create database. I said it was user db. Okay, can't create database exists. Okay, the database already exists. Nice. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and create a user. So create user. I said user db user. Okay, user db user, and the password is 12345. So identified by, I have 12345. Okay, and that's it. I've created it. So now that I've created the user, I'm going to grant him some permission. So I'm going to grant him update. Okay, select privileges on. Now the database, it will be user db dot star. Dot star means on all the tables. Okay, to actually the user db user arrobas local host. Okay, that is done. Okay, that is done. So I've created the user and I've granted him privileges on that database. So I'm going to exit this. Okay, and then now log in now with my own user I just created. So the user is user db user, and then now --, password. The password is 12345. Okay, access denied for using password. Okay, what's this? Let me try again. My secure --, user. I would say user db user, because that was the name. User db user. Okay. Let me try our local host, and then --, password, and then 12345, and it says the access denied. So what is this? Guess it's a pass. It been created, you know, my secure --, user root. Okay, exit. My secure --, user db user --, password 12345. Oh putain, why is this thing disturbing me? Damn it. Okay, let us use root. Okay, let us use root. No, we're not going to use root. Wait, let me check. Okay, what am I doing badly? Na 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 na. Okay, I did everything without any problem, so what is wrong? Why is it not running? User DB user password, so why is it not running? Let me create another user. Create user me. Identified by me 123. Oh, sorry. My secure --, user root. Then I say create user me. Identified by me 123. I've created the bitch. Okay, now I grant create delete select update alter. Why did I forget? You can create, you can delete, you can select, you can update, you can alter. Okay, on user db dot star to me. Okay, let me check that out. I created, so now I exit and then I try to user me hyphen hyphen password. I say me 123. What is this? Why would this work and the other one doesn't work? This is strange. Okay, let's just say that's it. So I'm going to change here. It's still user DB, but I've created a new user. The username is now me, and the password is me 123. So I save it and I come here and here. No, not here. Here. Yeah, yeah. And I change it here. So I have me. And I have me. Great. So now, yeah, I'm going to create use user DB. Okay. Now, yeah, I'm going to create table users with the following values. Okay, I'll just have an int, like an int, a varchar. Sorry, the name first. The name will be, I'll call it name or username. Yeah, name. Name, it's going to be a varchar. I'll say 50. And then, why, just for the sake of it, let me just say it's a primary key. Okay, put a question mark, and then I have age, which is an int. I need it to be unsigned. Okay, unsigned. So I close it and I put my question mark. Okay, it has been created. So now to show, describe users. Okay, it has been created. And if I try to select anything from it, select star from users, it actually prints nothing. So it says it's empty. So basically it's already running. So let's try and run our program. Okay, let's try and run it. So like I have, okay, everything is running. So let me try and run this guy to store a value. Okay, store a value. So now you can see it's asking me to enter my name. I'm going to say the first in. So now when I hit enter, it says enter your age. Now the age I'm going to enter is 19 or 15. Why 15? Yeah, or 15 plus 19. 15 plus 19 is 34. So I'm going to say 34. 34. So now when I hit enter, they throw something. They say java.lang or name, model create user, this that store 18. This my model.create user, and they say model 26 con.prepare statement, blah blah blah. Oh, I actually put this before the connection. Tu vois les erreurs. I actually put this before I created the connection. Can you imagine? Before I actually created the connection, I put him. So that's why the error was shown. So let me start again. Enter your name. I'm going to say the first enhancer. Now enter your age. I'm going to say 34. And then I hit enter. And now I have new guys. So they say blah blah blah, insert command, deny. I forgot to grant him the insert command. oh my bad. So I'm going to exit and then enter as root, user root. Okay, now as my root, I will say grant insert. I actually forgot insert on. User DB dot star to who was that again? Me. Okay, that was me, I think. Me. Okay, so now I can actually exit. Okay, and then now enter as hyphen hyphen user me hyphen hyphen password and say me 123. I enter and I say use user DB. Great. So now I come back here and I try to run this for the third time, hoping that this will be the last, the first enhancer, and again each, this time I'm going to say 35, right? No, 37, actually this is the third time I'm doing this. Okay, they say user was successfully added. So we can actually come here and try to see if it was added, but let's try here first. Okay, let me try and run this one. Okay, let me just hit enter here. Like, let me actually try and run this guy. Okay, let me run this guy. Wow, the name of the user is the first enhancer. His or her age is this. Okay, it actually works. So when I come here and I say, okay, select star from users, and that is it. It's now in the database. Okay, so David, basically this is it. It's really a long video, like 40 minutes. Damn it, 40 minutes. Sorry for my language, but it was actually a long stuff. So basically this is how you create a connection in the Java. Okay, you have the in your project, you need to import the connector for the particular database you're using. After, you can go to the website of the database, like MySQL or any other, MongoDB, what you think you can use, and get the connector. And then you have to know some statements, some stuff about SQL, okay, about the statements, the prepared statements and everything, connections and everything, okay, about databases in fact, okay. And then now you just have to know how to play around with the driver manager. That is actually what you use to create the connection. Okay, driver manager dot get connection. This is the URL that you enter for the GDBC, MySQL server, localhost, this, that, that. Okay, so basically this is it. I hope it helps you. And all those that are looking at this, okay, I hope it helps you. This was simple stuff with console, but you see that if you have a graphical user interface, all you will need to do, all I needed to do here was actually to communicate with my database, was actually create this model class, okay, and actually access a service from it, which is create user. Okay, that's basically all I did. The only other things now are what I use. In this case, I decided to use a console. Okay, here you could have used any other stuff, or this, for example, if you were using the MVC, this could be in your controller, obviously, based on some action that the user did, okay, or actually triggered. Okay, so I hope it was fun. To me, it was fun. We had some errors, of course, and it was fun debugging. So see you next time for another video.